Welcome to the Tennis Warehouse Racquet Review of the Volkl VSENSOR 9. Volkl completely overhauls their 9 racquet line with a brand new frame design and string pattern. The VSENSOR 9 features a wide open 16 by 17 pattern to open up the sweet spot and provide loads of spin potential. C3 material technology has also been added to parts of the frame to improve power, stability, and feel. First up, we're here with Jason, and we know Volkl made a big change compared to the Super G version of this racquet, but you were just saying it reminded you of your old racquet of choice, the Power Bridge 9. So tell us what you thought of this one.
Well, I really like this racquet, and like you said, it reminded me of the older versions, like the Power Bridge 9 or like the Organics 9. And to me, this just didn't feel like the Super G 9 at all. This one, because of the string pattern, this one has that 16 by 17 string pattern, and it was a lot more powerful than the Super G 9. A lot more spin, a lot more power. I felt like this one was probably the most stable 9 I've ever play tested from Volkl. I really liked it from the ground. I felt like I was able just to swing away, very whippy, nice power, a lot of spin on it. Really, I think my one downside, it would be just a slight knock, would just be the handle shape. I've always kind of had an issue with the rectangular handle shape. I kind of like it a little bit more round. But I thought this racquet complemented my game really well, allowed me to hit out, put a lot of spin on my shots from both wings. So yeah, really enjoyed this racquet.
Next up, we're here with Michelle, and I know that you've typically struggled a little bit with the wide open pattern rackets before, but how did this one work out for you?
Yeah, during this playtest, I just felt like something was missing, and I don't know if it was a bit of plow through for my personal taste or some weight or stability. So I definitely did have some struggles with this racquet. On the plus, I found really easy depth and good arc on my balls without really having to try hard to get that depth and spin. However, when I was in point situations, I found it to play a little erratic. And then defensively, I really did not enjoy this racquet because it was hitting short balls and putting me in trouble for the next shot. So unfortunately, that wasn't great. At net, I struggled again a little with the stability, and I didn't find it to be as solid as what I like at the net. And on serves, I just tried to key in more on spin potential and really getting a kick and a good slice out of this racquet. Again, on returns, kind of the same story, just not enough behind the ball. I definitely would add some weight to the tip of the racquet. But definitely a great racquet for a player looking for tons of spin and an easy racquet to hit with.
Next up, we're here with Troy. We got some differing opinions from the other playtesters, and I know you were on the review of the Super G9. So how did this one work out for you? How did it compare to the previous version?
Yeah, I felt like this racquet kind of grew on me throughout the playtest. I haven't tested too many spin-type string patterns, and that was one thing that, you know, kind of I got used to throughout the playtest. The thing I noticed, you know, you get a really high launch angle, you get easy net clearance, but the faster you swing with, you know, top spin, the more the ball's just gonna dip down in the court. So once I kind of got used to that depth control, I felt like I was swinging freely from the baseline, and the racket's really fast. So anytime I was, you know, on defense, on the run, I could flick the racket and just get tons of spin, dip the ball cross court. So I kind of liked that as I got used to it. Going back to my personal racket with the dense string pattern, it was kind of hard to get used to the different feel of those two, but good spin potential. Compared to the Super G, I did feel like the open string pattern helped with the sweet spot. The previous one kind of had a really tiny sweet spot with that really tight string pattern, but that was the main difference for me. If I would do one thing is, you know, definitely add some weight to the head of this racket, and I think I'd prefer it with just a slightly more dense string pattern. Maybe a 16-19 would probably be more comfortable.
I was also on this play test. I also got to play test one of the 8s in this racquet line as well, and kind of as an overall, I'm really enjoying the VSENSOR update. This whole line, I think, just has the best feel for me compared to other Volkl rackets in the past. I feel a lot more connected to the ball. It's a little crisper, and for me, that's kind of just a general upgrade in terms of feel to the entire VSENSOR racquet line. As for this 9, I liked it over the previous version. Definitely much more wide open sweet spot. And kind of like Troy said, it's got a little different launch angle, kind of like the Wilson Spin Effect rackets. This one reminded me a lot of the Wilson Blade 98S. You get that higher launch angle, but you also, when you accelerate, you can get that ball dipping down at the court. So I was finding, especially on my forehand, where I tend to hit with a lot of topspin, I was really generating a lot of easy depth and a lot of spin on my forehand. However, unfortunately, on flatter shots, or kind of like what Michelle was saying, when you kind of amp it up in points and you go for a little bit more, I thought there was a little loss in control. Also at the net, I had the same experience. It was a little tough for me to aim for small targets in the court, and same thing on the serve and the return. I just found myself bringing those targets a little bit closer to the middle of the court to give myself some room for air. But if you like the spin effect rackets, looking for something light, maneuverable, super spin friendly, this one's definitely worth a try. For this playtest, we had this racket strung up with Solinco Hyper G, right around 54 pounds. If you want to learn more, be sure to come to tenniswarehouse.com.